Right friends, welcome back. Good morning, New India. The first one is meeting held at Rashtrapati Bhavan regarding expansion of Smart Gram Initiative. This Smart Gram Initiative is by Rashtrapati Bhavan and now it is extended from 5 villages to 100 villages. You may have a pertinent doubt for what purpose this Smart Gram Initiative is intended. The purpose of this Smart Gram Initiative is to sensitize projects in the fields of agriculture, skill development, energy, education, health, employment generation, and at the same time developing entrepreneurship. So, Smart Gram Initiative is the initiative of Rashtrapati Bhavan and now it is extended from 5 villages to 100 villages and this 100 villages will be situated in Haryana. Please don't forget. Look into the next one. This is with regard to WPI as well as IIP and all of you are familiar with GDP as well as Consumer Price Index. These two are based on the index pertaining to 2011-12, but the indices pertaining to Wholesale Price Index as well as IIP, they pertain to 2004-05 base. Now the government decided to shift the base of WPI as well as IIP to 2011-12. That is about this news item. Please go through it. Already GDP, GVA, these have been changed as well as consumer price index is also being calculated pertaining to the base year of 2011-12. Now wholesale price index as well as index of industrial production, these two will also shift to 2011-12 base. Right, look into the next one. This is with regard to DIPP and WIPO. These are going to set up technology and innovation support centers. Here, don't forget, DIPP is the nodal authority in our country for intellectual property that is under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. You may have a doubt with regard to WIPO. WIPO is the World Intellectual Property Organization. This is the organization based in Geneva. It is one of the specialized agencies of United Nations. And here, these two, WIPO and DIPP, signed an agreement to establish technology and innovation support centers. You may have a doubt, what is the meaning of technology and innovation support centers? This provides innovators in developing countries with access to locally based high quality technology information. And here one important point is the services include access to online patent and non-patent scientific and technical resources. The basic purpose is to have access to the required resources in developing countries. So that is the initiative of technology and innovation support centers. Now they will be established in our country also. Right, look into the next one. India unanimously elected as head UN Habitat. This is United Nations Human Settlements Program. Right now, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu will chair the Governing Council meeting which is being held in Nairobi. And another important aspect is with regard to this UN Habitat. UN Habitat is the organ of United Nations organization that promotes socially and environmentally sustainable human settlements across the world. And it is also pertinent to note that it is only the third time that India has been elected to lead the important organization after 1988 and 2007. Another point is UN Habitat reports to United Nations General Assembly. And one more important aspect is it is intergovernmental policy making and decision making body, and the Governing Council of UN Habitat seeks to promote integral and comprehensive approach to human settlements. Right, look at the next one. Union Home Minister chairs the review meeting of left-wing extremism affected states. And please don't forget, in our country, there are 10 left-wing extremism affected states and yesterday meeting was held. Most important point here is one doctrine was devised. This is a Samadhan. This Samadhan doctrine is for security operations. So here this operational doctrine or operational strategy, Samadhan, to fight left wing extremism, and the full form of Samadhan is given here, S for smart leadership, A for aggressive strategy, like that. Please go through it. So from examination perspective, Samadhan is the doctrine which was given by the Home Minister to fight left-wing extremism districts, right? Or you can say to fight left-wing extremism, right? Then the next one is center to tap Mahatma Gandhi Narega funds to make Saraswati flow again. And here the idea of the minister is basically to look at the paleo channels. In the paleo channels, there is a lot of silt accumulation is there, and they can be utilized basically to improve the groundwater storage. Lot of silt might have accumulated over these paleo channels. Paleo channels are the remnants of rivers in good olden days. So over that, lot of silt might have accumulated, and the minister feels that they are the best. The paleo channels are the best as far as water storage is concerned. Here this K.S. Valdia panel stated that Saraswati river existed. This is one important aspect. And paleo channels are remnants of defunct rivers. And if you look at important findings, this is Saraswati Markanda rivulets. This is Saraswati Markanda rivulets in Haryana were the water courses of the eastern branch of Himalayan river. And at the same time, Ghaggar Patiali channels were the western branches, and these branches met at Shatrana, 25 kilometers south of Patiala, and flowed as a large river. The river emptied out into the sea, which is the present day Ran of Kutch. Please look into this picture. This is the location of Ran of Kutch. Right? Please look into the next one. China offers to rename OBOR to allay India's fears. Chinese ambassador, in fact, pointed to four-pronged strategy to manage the differences between India and China, because this is 60-nation Belt and Road Initiative, and around 100 countries are sending their official delegations. India is not sending any official delegation under the circumstances. The Chinese ambassador to India talked about 4-point solution to manage the differences, which includes a new treaty on cooperation and restarting talks on free trade agreement. Next one is early resolution to the border dispute, as well as aligning this Belt and Road Initiative with India's Act East policy. But the important point to note is this sovereignty issues still remain. Right. Look into the next one. 2000 strong Cobra force for Sukma. Sukma is in Bastar region of Chhattisgarh, and these areas are worst affected because of left-wing extremism. And left-wing extremism districts, there are around 106 districts, and the government recently tried to remove some of the districts from left-wing extremism. And please don't forget, these are spread over 10 states of the country. And under the circumstances, here this Cobra force, 2000 strong Cobra force will go for Sukma. Sukma is worst affected. And what is meant by Cobra? Cobra is Commando Battalion for Resolute Action. Commando Battalion for Resolute Action. Then after decisive win, Macron to take over on Sunday. So it is decisive victory in the France elections. So 66% voted for Emmanuel Macron, and Marine Le Pen got 34%. And we are going to deliberate on this in the capsule part. Then this is France, and France has got coastline both towards Atlantic as well as Mediterranean. This is very important. And if you look at the next news item, Ports Authority concerned over Hambantota. This Hambantota port, in fact, the phase one was constructed with Chinese assistance. And now after the completion of phase one, In fact, it became white elephant, and under these circumstances, now the fresh agreement with China with regard to the development of this Hambantota port, and in fact the Sri Lankan authority, that is Ports Authority, also expressed some fundamental concerns, right? And please go through this article. And the next article is Center to Raise with US Non-Tariff Barriers Curbs Affecting Exports of Goods Made in India. Tariff barriers, non-tariff barriers. Tariff barriers, look into this. These are taxes on imports which can be levied either per ton or on value, and they are occasionally imposed on exports also. And what are the purposes of imposing tariff barriers? I have given here, please go through it. And non-tariff barriers. Non-tariff barriers are basically restrictions on imports or exports by a government in the form other than taxes, right? If some taxes or duties are imposed, tariff barriers. Other than taxes or duties, non-tariff barriers. Non-tariff barriers are restricting exports or imports through the mechanisms other than imposition of tariffs. And if you look at it, they may take the form of import quotas, subsidies, customs delays, technical barriers, and other systems. Rules and regulations will be totally tightened so as to reduce imports. These are non-tariff barriers. Non-tariff barriers include import licensing, rules for valuation of goods at customs, pre-shipment inspections, rules of origin, etc. Right, friends, this concludes today's Good Morning New India. Have a nice day. Thank you.